Okay, we are live.
Okay, welcome everyone to the WishWin Spellathon 2021 Online National Championship. And congratulations to all the students who participated in the Spellathon this year. And congratulations to everyone who made it to the semifinals of Spellathon 2021. Thank you to the volunteers and judges especially for helping with the Spellathon this year and helping the spelling community. Let me first introduce the judges. Judges, please say hi or raise your hand so that everyone knows who's who. Bharadwaj will be the Bharadwaj, who's on WishWin's board of directors, will be the Zoom host, and he will be managing the live stream as well. He will also be the one you would go to in case there is an appeal. Just drop him a message on the Zoom chat, and he should be able to address that. The rules will be covered later by Soham, okay, as to how you should do that. And YJ, that's me, hello once again, and I will be the process judge to make sure that the handoffs are happening correctly and the Spellathon event is being conducted smoothly. Rohan Raja will be your pronouncer and bell judge today for this session. He is an upcoming sophomore at high school, and he was a winner at WishWin's 2018 Spellathon. He competed in the Scripps National Spelling Bee for 2 years, and his efforts culminated in 2019 when he won the Scripps National Spelling Bee along with the other co-champs. Good job, Rohan. And in addition to spelling, he enjoys playing tennis and spending time with family. Rohan has been a key member of the WishWin family since 2018. Thank you for all your help, Rohan, and welcome.
Thank you.
Next, we have Soham Sukhatankar. He will be your roots and words judge. Soham was the 2018 WishWin champion and the 2019 Scripps National Spelling Bee co-champion. He has been part of the WishWin family since 2018, and he's a rising sophomore at St. Mark's School in Texas. His hobbies include reading, coding, and studying biology. Wow. He says he's very grateful for the opportunity to be a judge at WishWin. That's really nice of you, Soham, and thank you for all your help throughout, and he wishes everyone the best of luck. Next, we have Snigdha Nandipati, who will be the word judge and the rounds announcer for this session. Snigdha is a recent Yale graduate, a non-fiction author, and a patient advocate at the San Francisco Clinic. Her book, A Case of Culture, was recently launched. That is amazing, Snigdha. Congratulations on that. And Snigdha has participated in Spelling Bee since she was in third grade, and she became the Scripps National Spelling Bee champion in 2012. She's excited to return to the world of spelling with WishWin. Thank you, Snigdha, and a warm welcome to you.
Thank you for having me.
And next we have Sahana, who will be your timing judge today. She's a freshman going to Lebanon Train High School in Texas, and she has been part of the WishWin family since 2017. First as a participant and from the past 2 years as a volunteer. That's very nice. And she likes music, singing and playing in the band, dancing also. And she likes to participate in competitions. That's really nice, Sahana. And welcome to everyone. Good luck to all the students who are here. Thank you. Soham, over to you.
So, first of all, congratulations and welcome to the WishWin 2021 Spellathon. We are live streaming the Spellathon on WishWin's Facebook page. Parents, relatives, and friends may watch the live stream on Facebook from a separate room. As a quick reminder, your primary and secondary video should be on during the entire competition. The WishWin semifinals consist of oral spelling rounds with elimination. If you misspell a word, you will be eliminated. At the time, you may switch off both the primary and secondary devices and watch the rest of the competition on Facebook. You are not allowed to get any external help, for example, from a phone or any other device or person. While spelling, your hands should be visible in the Zoom video frame. If you want to take a break, please take a break right after your word. Also, you must be present well in advance of your next word. If you have any appeals, please send a message to the Zoom meeting host, WishWin Bharadwaj. The appeal must be sent before the end of the round. About 8 to 10 students from each group will advance to the grand finals next week. The Merriam-Webster Unabridged Online Dictionary will be the official source for words and their information. And finally, decisions made by the judges and organizers are final. So, best of luck, everyone.
Good luck, everyone.
Rohan, are we ready?
Yeah, we can start.
Okay. Judges ready? Students ready?
Okay.
So who's going to be announcing the names of the first contestant? I mean, starting from the first. Rohan, will you be able to do that?
Yes, I'll do that.
Okay.
First is speller 301, Kobe Barron.
Your word is skatee. Skatee. Can you speak up a bit? I can't hear you clearly.
This makes it louder. Skatee. S-K-E-T-E.
Skatee. That's correct.
Next, we have speller 303.
Hi.
Hello. Can you please put your hands in the frame? Your word is mackle.
M-A-C-K-E-L. Mackle.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is M-A-C-L-E. Good try.
Thank you.
Congratulations on making it this far.
Next is speller 304.
Hello.
Hello, I can't see you.
Okay,
I'm back to you. Your word is epificer.
Epificer. Can I have all the information, please?
Epificer is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a skilled or artistic worker. The first part is from Latin, and the second part is from English. And the sentence is, the epificer made a beautiful wood vase for me. Epificer.
Okay, epificer, just to make sure, does this contain the Latin root AP meaning cook, I mean point?
I don't see that here.
Okay, epificer, am I saying this correctly?
Can you say it again?
Epificer.
Epificer, yeah, I think you're close. Yeah.
Epificer. Opificer or epificer?
Epificer.
Okay, epificer. O P I F I C E R. Epificer.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 305.
Hello, your word is pencil.
Say it again.
Pencil.
Pencil. Definition, please.
Pencil means the rite in Hinayana Buddhism of undertaking ceremonially a set of five precepts of morality.
Pencil. Any other pronunciations?
Yes. There is pencil and pencil.
Pencil. Language of origin, please.
Pencil is from Sinhalese.
Pencil. P-A-N-S-I-L, pencil.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 306.
Hi.
Hello. Your word is a homonym, so I'm going to give you all the information. The word is reamer. Reamer is the only pronunciation. It's a plural noun, and it means a complex form of versified saga or treatment of episodes with a saga that's popular in Iceland from the 15th century. The word is from Old Norse, and the sentences reamer are stanzaic, and stanzas normally have four lines. Reamer.
Reamer. Am I pronouncing it correctly?
Sounds right.
Could you repeat the definition?
Yes, reamer means a complex form of versified saga or treatment of episodes from the sagas popular in Iceland from the 15th century. Reamer.
Reamer. R-I-M-U-R. Reamer.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Speller 310.
Hi.
Hi. I can't see you yet. Now I can see you. Your word is trochanter.
Trochanter. May I have all the information?
The word can be pronounced trochanter or trochanter, and it's a noun, and it means a rough prominence at the upper part of the femur of many vertebrates, serving usually for the attachment of muscles. The word went from Greek to New Latin, and the sentence is, there is a slight ridge on the femur in the place of a third trochanter.
Trochanter. T-R-O-C-H-A-N-T-E-R. Trochanter.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 315.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is Alevin.
Alevin, can I have all the information, please?
Alevin is a noun. It means a young fish. The word is from French, and the sentence is, the students learned about the development of a trout from the alevin to the fingerling of to the adult stage. Alevin.
Can you please repeat the definition?
A young fish.
Can I have the language of origin?
Alevin is from French.
Can you please repeat all the information?
Sure. Alevin is the only pronunciation. It's a noun. It means a young fish, and the word is from French. The students learned about the development of a trout from the alevin to the fingerling to the adult stage. Alevin.
Alevin. A. L. A. B. I. N. Alevin.
Good try. You are just off by one letter. The correct spelling is A-L-E-V-I-N. Great job.
Next up is speller 317.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is cornichon.
Cornichon. May I have all the information, please?
Cornichon is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a sour gherkin usually flavored with tarragon. The word is from French, and the sentence is, decorate each toast with a few capers and one or two slices of cornichon.
Cornichon. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There's just the one, cornichon.
Cornichon. C-O-R-N-I-C-H-O-N. Cornichon.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 318.
Hello?
Hello. Your word is burgrave.
Burgrave, may I have the definition, please?
Burgrave means the military governor of a German city in the 12th and 13th centuries.
Can I have the language of origin?
Burgrave comes from two German parts.
May I have it in a sentence, please?
As a burgrave of the city, he devoted himself to preserving peace in the city.
Burgrave. B-U-R-G-R-A-V-E. Burgrave.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Our next speller is speller 319.
Your word is vigorous.
Can you repeat the word?
Vigorous.
Can I have all the information?
Vigorous is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means interest paid to a moneylender. The word is from Yiddish, and the sentence is, in terms of building regular traffic, state lawmakers have every urgency to ensure that customers pay no more than the usual 10% vigorous.
Can you repeat the definition?
Vigorous means interest paid to a moneylender.
Vigorous. V-I-G-O-R-I-S-H. Vigorous.
That is correct.
Next is speller 321.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is cognizant.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Cognizant.
May I have all information, please?
Cognizant is the only pronunciation. It's an adjective, and it means free from sound or noise, silent. It comes from two Latin parts, and the sentence is, it was really amazing to see the kids sit contestant at the recital hall.
Contestant?
Contestant.
Contestant. Contestant.
Oh, wait. Listen again. Contestant.
Contestant.
Yeah, that's better.
Contestant. Contestant.
Wait. Listen again. Contestant.
Contestant.
Yeah, that's better.
Contestant.
Contestant. That's, yeah, that's a little better.
Contestant. Can you say the definition again, please?
Yes, it means free from sound or noise, silent. Contestant.
Contestant. Contestant.
Contestant.
Contestant. C O N T I S C E N T. Contestant.
Good try, but I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The correct spelling is C-O-N-T-I-C-E-N-T.
Okay, thanks.
Next is speller 323.
Hi.
Hello, your word is Tufan.
Tufan. Maybe some other information?
Tufan is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a violent storm. The word is from Arabic, and the sentence is, the old oak tree did not survive the Tufan.
Okay. Tufan. Tufan. Am I saying it correctly?
Tufan. Can you say it again?
Tufan.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Okay. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Just the one, Tufan.
Okay. Tufan. Tufan. T-U-F-A-N. Tufan.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 325.
Hi.
Hello, can you put your hands in the frame? Your word is allulet.
Allulet. Can you give me all of the information, please?
Yeah, the word is allulet. It's an adjective, and it means producing, filled with, or marked by howling. The word is from Latin, and the sentence is, it was hard for Daniel to forget his mom's allulet cry.
Allulet. U L U. L-A-N-T.
That's correct.
Next is speller 326.
Hi.
Your word is xanthic.
Xanthic. Can I have the definition, please?
Xanthic means of, relating to, or tending toward a yellow color.
Xanthic. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Xanthic. Okay, so it comes from two parts. The first part went from Greek to French, and the second part went from Latin to French.
Xanthic. Can I have the part of speech, please?
Xanthic is an adjective.
Xanthic. Does it have the Greek xanth meaning yellow?
Yes, it does.
Xanthic. Does it have the Latin adjective ending ic meaning relating to?
You're on the right track.
Xanthic. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is xanthic and xanthic.
Xanthic. Could you repeat the word, please?
Xanthic.
Xanthic. X A N T H I C. Xanthic.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 328.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is alcohol.
Can you say the definition?
Yes, bacchanal means a fine fellow. Oh, keep your hands up.
Language of origin?
Yeah, sure. So, bacchanal came from two French parts, and then it passed into folk etymology.
Can you give me all the information?
Sure. Bacchanal is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a fine fellow. It came from two French parts and then passed into folk etymology. And the sentence is, my mother agreed that my friend is a bacchanal.
Bacchanal. B-O-C-O-C-K. Bacchanal.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is B-A-W-C-O-C-K. Good try. Great job on making it this far.
Next, we have speller 329.
Hello?
Hello, I can't see you yet. Okay, now I can see you. Can you put your other hand up? Thank you. Okay, the word is katak.
Katak. Can I have all the information, please?
Katak is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means an intricate dance of northern India that includes passages of narrative pantomime. The word is from Bengali, and the sentence is, Katak is indigenous to northern India and developed under the influence of both Hindu and Muslim cultures. Katak.
Katak. Am I saying it correctly?
Katak.
Katak. K-A-T-H-A-K. Katak.
That's correct.
Next, we have speller 330.
Hello, your word is a homonym, so I'm going to give you all the information. The word is shaw. It's an interjection, and it's used to express irritation, disapproval, contempt, or disbelief. The word is from unknown origin, and the sentence is Shaw called my mom after she found out my score on the latest test. Shaw.
Okay, shaw. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Shaw is the only pronunciation.
Okay. Shaw. P-S-H-A-W. Shaw.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 331.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is mitimus.
Can you repeat the word, please?
Mitimus.
Mitimus. Mitimus. Am I saying this correctly?
Mitimus. Sounds right.
Mitimus. Can I have the definition, please?
Mitimus means a warrant of commitment to prison.
Mitimus. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Mitimus is from Latin.
Mitimus. Can I have the part of speech, please?
Mitimus is a noun.
Mitimus. Can you use this word in a sentence, please?
Jonathan was asked to sign a mitimus.
Mitimus. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Just the one, mitimus.
Mitimus. Does this come from the Latin mitere, meaning to stand?
Yes, it does.
Mitimus. M-I-T-T-I-M-U-S. Mitimus.
That is correct.
Next is speller 352.
Your word is Colleen.
Colleen, may I have all the information?
Colleen is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means an Irish girl. The word is from Irish Gaelic, and the sentence is, one of Rita's closest friends is Ava, a young Colleen.
Colleen, may I have the language of origin?
Colleen is from Irish Gaelic.
Sorry, thank you. Colleen, C-O-L-L-E-E-N, Colleen.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 354.
Your word is acicula.
Acicculum. Can I have all the information?
Sorry, I think you misheard me. Acicculum.
Acicula. Can I have all the information?
Sure. Acicula is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a needle-like spine, bristle, or crystal. The word comes from two Latin parts, and the sentence is, removing a porcupine's acicula from your skin can be an incredibly difficult and painful task. Acicula.
Acicula. A-C-I-C-U-L-A. Acicula.
That is correct.
Next is speller 363.
Your word is Celiar.
Can I have all the information?
Can you put your hands back up, please? Thank you. Okay, so Celiar is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means building material consisting of large blocks cut from a natural deposit. The first part went from Latin to Spanish, and the second part also went from Latin to Spanish. Sentences, many colonial buildings in the city of Arequipa are made of Celiar.
Okay, am I saying it correctly? Celiar.
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 Yeah, it's better.
Okay. Celiar. C. E. L. E. A. R.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is S-I-L-L-A-R. Great job on making it this far.
Next up is speller 370.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is Hygiene.
Hygiene. Can I have the definition, please?
Hygiene means other relating to health or to medical practice.
Hygiene. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Hygiene comes from two parts. The first is from Greek, and the second part is an English combining form.
Hygiene. Can I have all the information?
Hygiene is the only pronunciation. It's an adjective, and it means other relating to health or to medical practice. The first part is from Greek, and the second part is an English combining form. The sentence is, stress can have numerous hygiene consequences, including headaches, fatigue, and anxiety.
Can you repeat the word one more time?
Hygiene.
Hygiene. H? Y-G-E-I-A-N, hygiene.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 373.
Keep your other hand up, please. Okay. Your word is onegite.
Onegite, am I pronouncing it correctly?
Yes, onegite.
Can I have all the information, please?
It can be pronounced onegite or onegite, and it's a noun, and it means a pale amethyst gemstone penetrated by needles of goethite. It comes from two German parts, and the sentence is, Rachel was searching for an onegite to add to her gemstone collection. Onegite.
Onegite. O-N-E-G-I-T-E. Onegite.
That's correct.
Next is speller 374.
Hi.
Hi, your word is bijou.
Bijou, may I have all of the information?
Bijou is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a small, dainty, usually ornamental piece of delicate workmanship and fine material. The word is from French, and the sentence is, Ronnie bought a beautiful silver bijou for his wife. Bijou.
B-I-J-O-U. Bijou.
That is correct.
Next is speller 375.
Hi, your word is Vadal.
Can I please have all the information?
It can be pronounced Vadal or Weddle. And it's a verb, and it means to ski using a style of skiing in which the skier moves the rear of the skis from side to side, making a series of short, quick turns while following the fall line. The word is from German, and the sentence is, John learned how to wedel during skiing class. The word can be pronounced wedel or wedel.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is wedel and wedel.
Okay. Wedel. W-E-D-E-L. Wedel.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 402.
Your word is a homonym, so I'm going to give you all the information. The word is Merlin. Merlin is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means one of the solid intervals between embrasures of a battlemented parapet. It's from French, and the sentence is, during the battle, the soldiers placed a cannon on the Merlin and launched it against the enemy troops. Merlin.
Can you please repeat it?
Merlin.
M-E-R-L-O-T.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The correct spelling is M-E-R-L-O-N. Merlin. Good try. Great job making this one.
Next speller is speller 407.
Hello. Your word is... keep your hands up, please. Moami.
Moami, can I please have all the information?
Moami is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means the ruler or king of Rwanda, Burundi, Africa. It's from an African native name, and the sentence is, the Germans helped the Moami increase their control over Rwandan affairs. Moami.
Moami. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Just Moami.
Could you please repeat the language of origin?
It's from an African native name.
Moami. M-O-A-M-I. Moami.
Try. I'm sorry, the correct spelling is M-W-A-M-I. Great job on making this one.
Thank you.
Next is speller 409.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is a size.
Could you repeat the word?
A size.
A size. May I have all the information?
A size is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a statute or ordinance regulating weights and measures of the weight, measured proportions of ingredients, or price of articles sold in the market. The word is from Middle English.
Sorry.
Yeah, that's okay. The word is from Middle English, and it means the government passed an assize regulating the amounts of rice that were sold in the country. Assize.
Okay, assize. Can I have the sentence?
Assize. The government passed an assize regulating the amounts of rice that were sold in the country. Assize.
Assize. May I have the part of speech?
Assize is a noun.
Assize. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, assize.
Assize. Assize. A-S-S-I-Z-E. Assize.
That's correct.
Next is speller 411.
Your word is panya.
Panya?
Yeah, panya.
Panya, can I have all the information, please?
Panya is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a praiseworthy quality or virtue. And it's from Sanskrit, and the sentence is, sometimes the word panya is used interchangeably with virtue.
Can you please say the language of origin again?
It's from Sanskrit.
Okay. Could you please repeat all the information one more time?
Sure. Panya is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a praiseworthy quality or virtue. It's from Sanskrit, and the sentence is, sometimes the word panya is used interchangeably with virtue.
Okay. Panya, could you please use it in a sentence?
Sure. Sometimes the word panya is used interchangeably with virtue.
Okay. Panya, am I saying it correct?
Can you say it again?
Panya?
That sounds right, yeah. Panya.
Panya. P-U-N-Y-A. Panya.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next up is speller 413.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is sessile.
Okay, does this mean attached at the base?
Pretty close. It means permanently attached.
Okay, what's the language of origin?
It comes from two Latin parts.
Okay, does this come from Latin sedere, meaning to sit?
Yes, it does.
Okay, sessile. Can I have the language, can I have the part of speech, please?
Sessile is an adjective.
Okay, could you please use a word in a sentence?
The sessile filter-feeding organisms inhabit the wave-exposed shores.
Okay, sessile. S-E-S-S-I-L-E, sessile.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 414.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is lefse.
Lefse. Could I have all the information, please?
Lefse is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a large, thin potato pancake served buttered and folded. The word is from Norwegian, and the sentence is, using the leftover potatoes, they made lefse.
Lefse. Could I have the definition again?
Lefse means a large, thin potato pancake served buttered and folded. Lefse.
Lefse. L-E-F-S-E. Lefse.
That is correct.
Next is speller 415.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is Helsel.
Helsel, can you please repeat the word?
The word is Helsel.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, Helsel.
Helsel. Am I pronouncing it correctly?
Can you say it again?
Helsel.
Yeah, that sounds right.
Helsel. Can I please have the definition?
Helsel means a skin of the neck of poultry, stuffed usually with fat and flour. Helsel.
Helsel?
Yeah.
Helsel. Helsel. Can I have the sentence, please?
Yes. Helsel is a chicken neck skin stuffed with a flour-based mixture similar to kishka. Helsel.
Helsel, can I please have the language of origin?
Helsel is from Yiddish.
Helsel. Helsel. Can I please have the part of speech?
Helsel is a noun.
Helsel. Helsel.
30 seconds remaining.
Can I start over?
Yeah.
Helsel.
Yeah.
H. E. L. Z. E. L. Helsel.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 416.
Keep your hands up. Your word is Kriegspiel. I cannot hear
you. We can't hear you.
Hear me.
Yes, now I can hear you. Your word is Kriegspiel.
Kriegspiel?
Yes. Kriegspiel means a game in which blocks, pins, and flags representing contending forces and guns are moved about according to rules based on war conditions.
Can I have all the information, please?
The word can be pronounced Kriegspiel, 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 or Kriegspiel. The word is a noun, and it means a game in which blocks, pins, and flags representing contending forces and guns are moved about according to rules based on war conditions. The word comes from two German parts, and the sentence is, every now and then, my brother and I play Kriegspiel together.
Better speech, please.
Kriegspiel is a noun.
Kriegspiel. K-R-E-I-G-S-P-I-E-L, Kriegspiel.
I didn't hear that middle part. Did someone else hear it?
Yes. I think that is incorrect.
Did you hear an E-I? I think I heard an E-I.
Yeah, I heard K-R-E-I-G.
Yeah, okay. I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is K-R-I-E-G-S-P-I-E-L. Great job on making it this far.
Next is speller 417.
Hi.
Your word is rokai.
Rokai, can I have all the information, please?
The word can be pronounced rokai or rokai. It's a noun, and it means a style of ornament developed in the 18th century and characterized by forms derived from the artificial rockwork and pierced shellwork of the period. The word is from French, and the sentence is, the interior of the church is decorated with rokai.
Rokai, am I pronouncing it correctly?
Yes, the word came, yes, it's rokai or rokai.
Can you repeat the definition, please?
Yes. It means a style of ornament developed in the 18th century and characterized by forms derived from the artificial rockwork and pierced shellwork of the period.
Rokai. R-O-C-A-I-L-L-E. Rokai.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 419.
Do we have 419?
Oh yeah, 419 wasn't here.
Okay.
Okay, sorry. Yeah, 419, actually, I think he didn't come.
Okay, next.
Your word is, I can't see this word. Okay. Your word is labret. Could you hear me?
We can hear you, Rohan, but we cannot hear Dev, I think.
Can you hear me now? Hey, Brett, can I please have the definition?
Yes. Yes, so labret means an ornament worn in some cultures in a perforation of the lip.
Can I please have the language of origin?
Yes, labret, the first part is from Latin, the second part is from English.
Is this like the Latin labra, meaning axe?
I don't see that here.
Okay. Are there any alternates?
There is just the one, labret.
Labret. L-A-B-R-E-T, labret.
That's correct.
And
all right, that concludes round one. Great job, everyone. We're going to just tally up the scores really quickly and make sure we figure out who's going to the next round. So we can just
do one thing. Number 324 moved from group 2 to group 1. I don't think he's gone yet.
Oh. Oh, got it. Okay. No, that's sorry, not the end of the round.
Hello.
Okay. Can you please put your hands up in the frame? Thank you. Your word is veneri.
Can you please repeat the word?
Veneri.
Veneri. Am I saying it correctly?
Sounds right. Veneri.
Can I have all the information, please?
Veneri. Oh, sorry. So you can pronounce veneri or veneri. It's a noun, and it means an entire panel which is drawn for jury duty and from which a jury is to be selected. The word is from Middle English, and the sentence is, the jury pool, also known as the veneri, is first selected from among the community using a reasonably random method. Veneri or veneri.
Are there any alternative pronunciations?
Yeah, there is veneri and veneri.
V-I-N-I-R. Wait, can I start over?
Yes.
V-I-N-I-R-E-Y.
Good try, but I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-E-N-I-R-E.
Okay.
Great job.
All right, that concludes round one. Please give us a quick minute. We're going to tally up the scores and announce shortly who will be moving on to the second round.
Hello? Yes, so my secondary device is like running out of battery, so when I'm not spelling, can I just charge it?
Yes. Who was this?
It was Dave, 420.
Okay. Like that, we can just have the number, like how many are going to the next round, and we'll start the next round.
Great, sounds good. So we have 27 spellers who have spelled correctly, and 9 spellers who have spelled incorrectly, 1% being absent. So we will have 27 spellers moving on to round two.
Right. So, do you need a 5-minute break at this time, or are we good to go with the next round?
Should we continue or do you want a break?
I think we can continue.
Okay. Okay.
You're going to the next step, right? Go ahead.
Rohan, you're on mute.
Okay. So your word is gamut.
Gamut?
Gamut.
Okay. Can I have the definition, please?
Gamut means an entire range from one extreme to another. Gamut.
Okay. Can I bring the origin?
Gamut is from a modification of medieval Latin.
Can we use it in a sentence?
Yes. The book made me feel a gamut of emotions.
Any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one gamut.
Gamut. G-A-M-M-E-T, gamut?
Shy, I'm sorry, but the correct spelling is G-A-M-U-T.
With one N?
Sorry, wait, what?
Wait, say it again.
The correct spelling is G-A-M-U-T.
Oh.
Great, so I'll make it this far.
Next is speller 304.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is cholangitis.
Cholangitis. Can I have all the information, please?
Cholangitis is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means an inflammation of one or more bile ducts. The word came from two Greek parts and then passed into Latin. The sentence is, cholangitis is a rare infection. Cholangitis is a rare infection.
Cholangitis, does this contain the Greek suffix itis, meaning inflammation?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Cholangitis, am I saying the word correctly?
Cholangitis, yes.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just cholangitis.
Cholangitis, am I saying it correctly? Cholangitis?
Cholangitis, yeah, sounds right.
Cholangitis. C-H-O-L-A-N-G-I-T-I-S, cholangitis.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 305.
Hello.
Hello.
Five is not ready yet.
Yeah, I can see me.
Okay. The next number.
I don't see you in the frame.
I'm speaking.
Hello. Hello.
Yeah, just wait. I think he's telling you.
Okay. Yeah. I can see him
right now.
Okay, I can see him in the frame now. Your word is abbot.
Say it again.
Abbot.
Definition, please.
Abbot means the superior of a monastery for men. Abbot.
Abbot. May I have a language origin? Does it come from a name?
Abbot, it comes from Middle English.
Okay, abbot. Any other pronunciations?
There is just the one, abbot.
Abbot, can you use the sentence?
Yes, abbot means the superior of a monastery for men.
Okay, thank you for the sentence. Abbot. A-B-B-O-T, abbot.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Next is speller 306.
Okay. Your word is exegesis.
Exegesis. May I have all the information, please?
Exegesis is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means the act or process of explaining. The word went from two Greek parts to New Latin. And the sentence is, the student's exegesis of the novel was one of the best summaries the professor had ever read.
Is this from Greek exo meaning out?
You're on the right track.
Could you please repeat all of the information?
Yes. So the word's only pronunciation is exegesis. It's a noun, and it means the act or process of explaining. The word went from two Greek parts to New Latin, and the sentence is, the student's exegesis of the novel was one of the best summaries the professor had ever read.
And could you please repeat the word?
Exegesis.
Exegesis?
Exegesis.
Exegesis. And could you please repeat the language of origin?
Time is up.
Exegesis went from two Greek parts to New Latin.
You have to start spelling 306.
But you didn't give me a 30-second warning.
I just go ahead and start spelling now.
Yeah. Exegesis. Exegesis. Exegesis.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 310.
Hi.
Hi. I can't see you in the frame yet. Okay, now I can see you. Your word is Raymond.
Raymond, may I have all the information?
Raiment is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means clothing or garments. The word is from Middle English, and the sentence is, the bride's raiment was so detailed it took 4 months to suit. Raiment.
Can I have the part of speech?
Raiment is a noun.
Raiment. Raiment. R-A-M-A-N-T. Raiment.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. Correct spelling is R-A-I-M-E-N-T. Good job.
Thank you.
Next is speller 317.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is attrament.
Attrament. May I have the definition, please?
Attrament means a very dark substance.
Attrament. May I have the language of origin, please?
Attrament went from two Latin parts to Middle English.
Attrament. Could you repeat the definition, please?
A very dark substance.
Attrament. A-T-R-A-M-E-N-T. Attrament.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 318.
Hello.
So, your word is Afghan.
Afghan, may I have the definition, please?
Afghan means a blanket or shawl of colored wool knitted in or crocheted in strips or squares which are joined by sewing or crocheting.
May I have the language of origin, please?
Afghan is borrowed from Persian.
Afghan, may I have it in a sentence?
Afghan is mostly used as a decor element over a couch. Afghan.
Afghan. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is Afghan and Afghan.
Afghan. A F G H A N. Afghan.
That is correct.
Next, we have speller 319.
Your word is amantadine.
Can you repeat the word again?
Amantadine.
Do I have all the information?
Yes. So, amantadine means a drug used especially as a hydrochloride to prevent infection by interfering with virus penetration into host cells. It's a noun. Amantadine is the only pronunciation, and it comes from two ISB parts. The sentence is, the doctor gave me amantadine to help with my flu infection. Amantadine.
Amantadine. A-M-A-N-T-A-D-I-N-E.
That is correct.
Next, we have speller 323.
Hi. Your word is desonance.
Desonance. Oh, may I please have all the information?
The word can be pronounced desonance, 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 desonance. It's a noun. It means the ending of a word. The word went from Latin to Middle French. And the sentence is, the desonance of the word catching is the suffix ing.
Okay. Desonance. Maybe have the part of speech again?
Yes, desonance is a noun.
Okay, desonance. Desonance. D-E-S-I-N-E-N-C-E. Desonance.
Yes.
Thank you.
Next speller is 325.
Keep your hands in the frame. Thanks. Your word is farriery.
Farriery. Can I have all the information, please?
Farriery is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means the art or practice of one that attends a sick horse. The first part is an alteration of Middle English, and the second part is Middle English. And the sentence is, being a farriery takes a lot of craftsmanship and skill. Farriery.
Could you repeat the language?
Farriery, the first part is an alteration of Middle English, and the second part is Middle English.
Farriery. F-E-R-I-O-R-A-R-Y.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is F-A-R-R-I-E-R-Y. Good try.
Next is speller 326.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is... keep your other hand up in the frame, please. Thank you. Your word is hematocrit.
What?
Hematocrit.
What?
Okay. Sorry. The word is hematocrit.
Hematocrit. Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. So, hematocrit means an instrument for determining the relative amounts of plasma and corpuscles in body, usually by means of centrifugation.
Hematocrit. Am I saying the word right?
Can you say it again?
Hematocrit.
Sounds right.
Hematocrit. Does have the Greek hemat meaning blood?
You're on the right track.
Hematocrit. Does have the Greek crit or chris meaning to judge?
Yes, it does.
Hematocrit. Can I have the part of speech, please?
It's a noun.
Hematocrit. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is hematocrit and hematocrit.
Hematocrit. Could you repeat the word, please?
Hematocrit.
Hematocrit. H-E-M-A-T-O-C-R-I-T. Hematocrit.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 329.
Okay, the other hand up, please. Thank you. Your word is rondori.
Your audio is not on.
I can't hear you.
Rondori, can I have all the information, please?
Sure. Rondori is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means free practice between two judo students. The word is from Japanese, and the sentence is, Rondori, or free exercise, is practiced under conditions of actual contest. Rondori.
Rondori, can you please repeat the definition again?
Rondori means free practice between two judo students.
Rondori, am I saying this correctly?
Rondori.
Rondori. R O N D O R Y. Rondori.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is R A N D O R I. Great job.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 330.
Your word is Pergamenius.
Could I have all of the information, please?
Sure. The word's only pronunciation is Pergamenius. It's an adjective and means resembling parchment. The first part is from Latin and the second part is from English. Sentence is, they owned several Pergamenius codices, which are now in the Vatican Library. Pergamenius.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Pergamenius, and there's no alternate pronunciation.
Okay, thank you. Pergamenius. P-E-R-G-A-M-E-N-E-O-U-S. Pergamenius.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 331.
Okay, put your hands in the frame.
Hi.
Okay, thank you. Your word is poliomyelitis.
Poliomyelitis. Poliomyelitis. Can I have the definition, please?
Yes. Poliomyelitis means an infectious disease, especially of young children, that is caused by the poliovirus.
Poliomyelitis. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Poliomyelitis came from three originally Greek parts, and then it passed to New Latin.
Poliomyelitis, can I have the part of speech, please?
It's a noun.
Poliomyelitis, can you use this word in a sentence, please?
Sure. Humans began contracting rabies in 1929, first diagnosed as poliomyelitis.
Poliomyelitis, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, poliomyelitis.
Poliomyelitis, am I saying this correctly?
Can you say it again?
Poliomyelitis.
Yes, that sounds right.
Poliomyelitis, does this come from the Greek myelo, meaning bone marrow?
Yes, it does.
Poliomyelitis, does this come from the Greek itis, meaning inflammation of or tendency towards?
Yes.
Poliomyelitis. P O L I O M Y E L I T I S. Poliomyelitis.
That is correct.
Next, we have speller 352.
Your word is hukilau.
Hukilau. May I have all the information?
Hukilau is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a seine fishing party, often involving large number of peoples and much revelry. The word comes from two Hawaiian parts, and the sentence is, Elena and her husband met at the hukilau.
Hukilau. Can you repeat the definition?
It means a seine fishing party, often involving large numbers of people and much revelry.
Hukilau, may I have the language of origin again?
It comes from two Hawaiian parts.
Hukilau, H-U-K-I-L-A-U, Hukilau.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next we have speller 354.
Your word is fluxion.
Fluxion, can I have a definition?
Yes. Fluxion means the action of flowing or changing.
Fluxion, can I have all the information?
Fluxion is the only pronunciation. It's a noun and it means the action of flowing or changing. The word went from Latin to Middle French, and the sentence is, the granularity of salt may affect on the quality, fluxion, and bulk density of the product. Fluxion.
Fluxion. Fluxion. F-L-U-X-I-O-N. Fluxion.
Yes, that's correct.
Next is speller 370.
Hi.
Okay. Your word is jalopy.
Jalopy. Can I have the definition, please?
Jalopy means a dilapidated automobile.
Jalopy. Can I have the language of origin, please?
Jalopy has an unknown origin.
Jalopy. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is jalopy and jalopy.
Can I have the word one more time?
Jalopy.
Jalopy. J-A-L-O-P-Y. Jalopy.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 373.
Your word is keratin.
Can you please repeat the word?
Keratin.
Can I have all the information, please?
The word can be pronounced keratin or keratin. It's a noun and it means the reticular, usually stainable material of the cell nucleus. The first part is Greek and the second part comes from ISV. The sentence is, scientists hope to learn more about the keratin with the new spectral microscope. Keratin.
Can you please repeat all the information?
Sure. The word can be pronounced keratin or keratin. It's a noun, and it means the reticular, usually stainable material of the cell nucleus. The first part is from Greek, and the second part comes from ISV. The sentence is, scientists hope to learn more about the keratin with the new spectral microscope.
Keratin. Am I pronouncing it correctly?
Can you say it again?
Keratin.
That sounds right.
K-E-R-Y-A-T-I-N.
I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The correct spelling is K-A-R-Y-O-T-I-N.
Thank you.
Next is speller 374.
Your word is cassowary.
Cassowary, may I have all of the information?
Yes, so the word can be pronounced cassowary or cassowary, not much of a difference. It's a noun and it means any of several large rat-type birds of New Guinea, Australia, the Aru Islands, ran closely related to the emu. The word is from Malay and the sentence is Sam was excited to visit the zoo and see the cassowary for the first time.
Cassowary. C-A-S-S-O-W-A-R-Y. Cassowary.
That's correct.
Next is speller 375.
Your word is connivance.
Can I please have all the information?
Connivance, it can be pronounced connivance or connivance. It's a noun and it means corrupt or guilty assent to wrongdoing that involves knowledge of and failure to prevent or oppose it, but no actual participation in it. The word is from French and the sentence is, the prosecutor decided to press the mayor with charges of connivance in the city's transportation scam. Connivance.
Connivance. C-O-N-N-I-V-A-N-C-E.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 409.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is patrician.
Could you repeat the word?
Patrician.
Patrician?
Patrician. Yes.
Patrican, may I have all the information?
The word can be pronounced Patrican or Patrican. It's a noun, and it means paternal relatives. The first part is from Latin, and the second part is from Middle English. The sentence is, Count Hector relied on his wife's wealthy Patrican for the upkeep of the state. Patrican.
Patrican, does it come from the Latin root patri meaning father?
Yes, it does.
Okay, Patrican. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is Patrican and Patrican.
Okay, Patrican, Patrican. Could you repeat the sentence?
Yes. Count Hector relied on his wife's wealthy Patrican for the upkeep of his estate.
Okay, Patrican. P-A-T-R-I-K-I-N, Patrican.
That is correct.
Next, we have speller 411.
Keep your hands up, please. Thank you. Your word is Murray.
Murray?
Yeah.
This word is a homonym, by the way.
Oh, yeah. This word is a homonym, so I'll provide you all the information.
Okay.
The word can be pronounced Murray or More. It's a noun, and it means any of numerous, often brightly colored, savage, voracious eels constituting the family Murine. It's from Portuguese, and the sentence is, this summer, the city's aquarium plans to open a new wing featuring Murray eels. Murray.
Can you please give me all the information again?
Yes. So we're going to pronounce Murray or Moray. It's a noun, and it means any of numerous, often brightly colored, savage, voracious eels constituting the family Murinidae. It's from Portuguese, and the sentence is, this summer, the city's aquarium plans to open a new wing featuring Murray eels. Murray.
Murray. Can you please use the word in a sentence?
Yes. This summer, the city's aquarium plans to open a new wing featuring Murray eels. Murray or Moray.
Can you please use the word, can you give me the word's origin, please?
Yes, it's from Portuguese.
Okay. Can you please see the definition one more time?
Yes, it means any of numerous, often brightly colored, savage, voracious eels constituting the family Murinidae.
Murray?
Murray.
Murray. Am I saying it right?
Yeah, can you say it again?
Murray.
Murray.
I have 30 seconds remaining.
Yeah, that sounds right. Murray.
Singular, right?
Sorry, are you asking if it's singular?
It's an eel, right? The definition?
Yes.
Murray. M-O-R-A-Y. Murray.
That is correct.
Next, we have speller 413.
Hi. Okay. Can you please put your hands up? Okay, thanks. Your word is cassette.
Okay, cassette. May I please have all the information?
The word can be pronounced cassette, 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 cassette. The word is a noun, and it means a strip or slice as of sugar, beet, or potato, a chip. The word is from French, and the sentence is, the sugar factory decided it was time to replace their cassette maker. Cassette.
Okay, does this come from the French feminine diminutive et?
Yes, it does.
Okay, cassette. Could you please, can I have all the information again?
Yes, the word came pronounced cassette, 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 cassette. The word is a noun, and it means a strip or slice as of sugar, beet, or potato, a chip. The word is from French, and the sentence is, the sugar factory decided it was time to replace their cassette maker. Cassette.
Wait, does this come from the French masculine diminutive et?
You're on the right track.
I'm sorry, does this come from the French feminine diminutive et?
You're on the right track.
Could you repeat all the pronunciations again, please?
Yes. There is cassette, 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 cassette.
Okay, can I have language origin again?
Yes, the word is from French.
You have 30 seconds remaining.
Okay, cassette. C-O-S-S-E-T-T-E, cassette.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 414.
Okay. Your word is Cappelletti.
Cappelletti, can I have all the information, please?
Yes. So, Cappelletti is the only pronunciation. It means pasta in the form of little peaked hats filled with a savory mixture. It's from Italian, and the sentence is Max went for another serving of Cappelletti at the buffet. The word is pronounced Cappelletti.
Cappelletti. That's the language of origin again?
Cappelletti. Yeah, Cappelletti is from Italian. The Cappelletti is a plural noun.
Okay. Can I have the word again?
Cappelletti.
Cappelletti. C A P T A L E T T A E. Cappelletti.
Good try, but I'm sorry, the correct spelling is C A P E L L E T T I.
Great job.
Next, we have speller 415.
Okay.
Your word is Hierophant.
Hierophant. Can you please repeat the word?
Hierophant.
Hierophant. Okay, do you have any alternate pronunciations?
There is Hierophant, Hierophant, Hierophant.
Hierophant. Am I pronouncing this correctly?
Can you say it again?
Hierophant.
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 Yes, that's good.
Hierophant. Can you please give me the definition?
Hierophant means a priest in ancient Greece.
Can you repeat the definition again?
A priest in ancient Greece.
Hierophant. Can I please have the sentence?
Sure. The Hierophant at the Pantheon offered a sacrifice to please Zeus. Hierophant.
Hierophant. Do you have the part of speech?
Yes. Hierophant is a noun.
Hierophant. Hierophant. Can you please repeat the word one more time?
Hierophant, Hierophant, Hierophant.
Hierophant. Can you have the language of origin?
You have 30 seconds remaining.
Yes, so it went from two Greek parts to late Latin. The word is Hierophant.
Hierophant. Hierophant. H I E R O P H A N T. Hierophant.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 417.
Hi, your word is quiddities.
Quiddities, can I have the definition?
Quiddities means trifling points or quibbles.
Okay, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, quiddities.
Can I have all the information, please?
Yes. Quiddities is the only pronunciation. It's a plural noun, and it means trifling points or quibbles. The word went from Latin to Medieval Latin to Middle English, and the sentence is, Mary was annoyed at the quirks and quiddities of the club's VIP membership program. Quiddities.
Can you repeat the language of origin?
Yes. It went from Latin to Medieval Latin to Middle English. Quiddities.
Quiddities. Am I pronouncing it correctly?
Quiddities.
Quiddities. Is that correct?
Yes, that's better.
Quiddities. Q U I D O T I E S. Quiddities.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is Q U I D D I T I E S. Great job.
Thank you.
Final speller of the round is speller 420.
Give me a sec. Is it Josh now? Yes, I can do it.
Your word is platin.
Can I have the definition?
Platin means a flat plate.
Platin?
Platin.
Platin. Can I have language of origin?
It went from Old French to Middle French.
Platin?
Platin.
Is this from the French masculine diminutive en?
I don't see that here.
Is it from the Latin suffix anus, anus?
I don't see that here.
Platin? Can I have the definition again?
A flat plate.
Platin. Are there any alternates?
Just platin.
Platin. Is it from, like, the French, or, like, Latin, inus?
Meaning?
A suffix?
Meaning?
Like, it's just a suffix, a inus, a suffix?
You need to be more specific.
I don't see that here, I'm sorry.
Okay.
30 seconds remaining.
The word, once platin. Again, is platin.
Platin. P-L-A-T-I-N.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is P-L-A-T-E-N.
All right. That concludes round two. Great job, everyone. So the results for this round, 8 spellers have spelled incorrectly, and 19 spellers will be moving on to round three. Those who have been eliminated in this round two are tied for 20.
Good job, everyone. Good luck.
I need to go now.
Okay.
Bye.
Would it be difficult for you to take your time as well, or?
Yes, I can do that. I know a few spellers requested if we could take a quick break.
Oh, okay.
That would be all right.
Yeah, about the judges, you want a 5-minute break? Rohan,
yeah.
Soham,
Snigdha. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, 5 minutes. Ashtonga timing. Because she's also entering there, right?
Yeah.
Is it possible? You should have the frame of the Arena Sahara has gone. Because timer has to be there.
Okay. Ready to start? About 8 to 10. Rohan, Soham, if you are back, we can get started. As what I end now, we'll start. Snigdha, I'll take care of the timing. So.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you.
Yeah. We can get started, Rohan.
Okay. So, can you call the first speller?
Oh, yeah, sorry about that. Okay, speller 304.
Hello. Okay, before you start, Rohan, I think Bharatwaj has taken over, right? As timing judge. Okay.
Okay. Your word is zero.
Zero, is this French?
Yes.
Zero, can I please have the definition?
A syrup of concentrated fruit juice, sugar, and water.
Okay. Zero, can I have all the information, please?
Yes. So, zero is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a syrup of concentrated fruit juice, sugar, and water. The word is from French, and the sentence is, the store sold sugary zero.
Zero, just to make sure, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, zero.
Okay, zero. Am I saying this correctly?
Yes, zero.
Zero. Zero. S I R O T. Zero.
That's correct.
Thank you.
This is speller 305.
Hi.
Can't see you yet. Okay, now I can see you. Your word is dipsis.
Say again.
Dipsis.
Dipsis, definition.
Dipsis means a serpent with a bite anciently supposed to produce intense thirst. Dipsis.
Dipsis, my language origin.
Dipsis went from Greek to Latin to Middle English.
Dipsis, any other pronunciations?
There is just the one, dipsis.
Dipsis, okay. Okay, dipsis. Give the sentence. Hello?
Yes. Jan said he didn't want to get bitten by... Yeah, the sentence... Can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm here. I can hear you.
Okay, so the sentence is... Jan said he didn't want to get bitten by a dipsis.
Okay, dipsis. D-I-P-S-A-S, dipsis.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next is spelling 306.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is arriero.
Arriero. May I have all the information, please?
Yes. Arriero is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means one who drives a mule or team of mules. The word is from Spanish, and the sentence is, the arriero transports coffee, maize, and wheat using the pack animals, especially mules. Arriero.
Okay, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, arriero.
Could you repeat all the information, please?
Yes. So the word's only pronunciation is arriero. It's a noun, and it means one who drives a mule or a team of mules. The word is from Spanish, and the sentence is, the arriero transports coffee, maize, and wheat using the pack animals, especially mules.
Arriero. Am I pronouncing it correctly?
Arriero.
Arriero. Could you please repeat the language of origin?
Arriero is from Spanish.
Okay, arriero. A R R I E R O. Arriero?
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next up is speller 317.
Hi.
Okay. Your word is bat mom.
Bat mom. May I have the definition, please?
Bat mom means an extension of the free foot in any direction followed by a beat against the supporting foot. Bat mom.
Bat mom. May I have the language of origin, please?
Batman is from French.
Batman. Could you repeat the definition again, please?
Yes. Batman means an extension of the free foot in any direction followed by a beat against the supporting foot.
Batman. B-A-T-T-E-M-E-N-T. Batman.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next we have speller 318.
Hi. Your word is JG.
JG?
Yes.
May I have the definition, please?
JG means a naval officer ranking below a lieutenant and above an ensign.
May I have the language of origin?
JG comes from two Middle English parts.
JG, can I have all the information, please?
Yes. JG is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a naval officer ranking below a lieutenant and above an ensign. The word comes from two Middle English parts. And the sentence is, the JG was very skilled and did what was best for the army. JG.
JG. May I have the language of origin again?
Yes. JG comes from two Middle English parts. JG.
JG. Could I have it in a sentence?
The JG was very skilled and did what was best for the army.
JG. J. A. G-I-E, G-G.
Try, but I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The correct spelling is J-A-Y-G-E.
Thank you.
Next we have speller 319.
Your word is nestic.
Nestic?
Nestic.
Definition.
Of or relating to memory.
And about information?
Yes, nesting is the only pronunciation. It's an adjective and it means of or relating to memory. The first part went from Greek to ISV and the second part is Middle English. The sentence is, the picture was a nesting reminder. Nesting.
Nesting. M-N-E-S-T-I-C, nesting.
That is correct.
Speller 323.
Hi.
Hi, your word is hamotzi.
Hamotzi. Can you give all the information?
Hamotzi is the only pronunciation. It's a noun and it means the recital of the Hebrew benediction over bread before meals. The word is from Hebrew and the sentence is they said the hamotzi for the bread before eating.
Okay, Hamotzi. H-A-M-O-T-Z-I, Hamotzi.
That's correct.
Thank you.
Next is speller 326.
Your word, keep your hands up, please. Your word is Lido.
What?
Lido.
Lido, can I have the definition, please?
Lido means a luxuriously equipped and fashionable beach resort.
Lido. Can I go into origin, please?
Lido comes from an Italian geographical name.
Oh. Lido, can I get the part of speech, please?
Lido is a noun.
Okay. Lido.
30 seconds more.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Just the one, Lido.
Lido. L. I. D. O. Lido.
That is correct.
Thank you. Sorry if I didn't know this.
No problem.
I was unmuted. Yeah. Next up, we have speller 330.
Your word is tigerine.
Could I have all of the information, please?
Yes. The word can be pronounced tigerine or tigerine. It's a noun and it means a woolly rhinoceros. The first part went from Greek to New Latin, and the second part also went from Greek to New Latin. And the sentence is, the wool of a tigerine is very soft and used in rugs. Tigerine.
Tigerine. T-I-C-H-O-R-R-H-I-N-E. Tigerine.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next, we have speller 331.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is mammalian.
Mammalian. Mammalian, can I have the definition, please?
Yes. Mammalian means a dome-shaped protuberance or elevation.
Mammalian, can I have the language of origin, please?
Mammalian is from French.
Mammalian, can I have the parting speech, please?
Mammalian is a noun.
Mammalian, can you use this word in your sentence, please?
Yes. They reached the summit of the Mammalian, from which Xenophon was descending.
Mammalian, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, Mammalian.
Mammalian. Can you repeat the language of origin, please?
Mammalian is from French.
Mammalian. Mammalian, can you repeat the definition, please?
A dome-shaped protuberance or elevation.
Mammalian, am I saying this correctly?
Yes, mammalian.
Seconds more.
Mammalian. M A M O L I N. Mammalian.
Good try, but I'm sorry, that's incorrect. The correct spelling is M A M E L O N. Great job.
Next we have speller 352.
Our word is megometer.
Megometer?
Megometer.
Megometer. May I have all the information?
The word is pronounced megometer. It's a noun and it means an instrument for the measurement of large electrical resistances. The first part is Greek, the second part is from a German name, and the third part is originally Greek. The sentence is, Daniel always used a high-quality megometer for his experiments. Megometer.
Can you repeat the pronunciation?
Megometer.
Megometer. May I have all... Sorry.
I think you may be hearing him wrong.
Yeah, it's megometer.
Megometer?
Yeah, it's a little bit better. Megometer.
Megometer.
Yeah, I think that's better.
Okay. May I have all the information again?
Yes, so the word is pronounced megometer.
It's a noun, and it means an instrument for the measurement of large electrical resistances. The first part is from Greek, the second part is from a German name, and the third part is originally Greek. The sentence is, Daniel always used a high-quality megometer for his experiments. Megometer.
Alright. Megometer. M-E-G-O-M-M-E-T-E-R. Megometer.
So close, you're just off by letter. The correct spelling is M-E-G-O-H-M-M-E-T-E-R.
All right.
Great job.
Next is speller 354.
Your word is Danubian.
Danubian. Can I have a definition?
Danubian means of, relating to, characteristic of, or bordering on the Danube River.
Okay, Danubian. Can I have all the information?
Yes. So the word can be found as Danubian, 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 or Danubian. It's an adjective, and it means of, relating to, characteristic of, or bordering on the Danube River. And the first part is from late Latin, the second part is from an English combining form. And the sentence is, Danubian people imported spondylus shells from the Mediterranean. Danubian.
Okay. Danubian. Danubian. D-A-N-U-B-I-A-N. Danubian.
That is correct.
Next we have speller 370.
Hi.
Can't see you yet. Okay, now I can see you. Your word is cockazelli.
Cockazelli. Can I have the definition, please?
Cockazelli means a variety of zucchini that is dark green with pale green longitudinal stripes and white to greenish white flavorful flesh.
Cockazelli. Can I have the language of origin?
It's probably from an Italian dialect.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, cockazelli.
Cockazelli. Can I have all the information, please?
Yes. Cockazelli is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a variety of zucchini that is dark green with pale green longitudinal stripes and white to greenish white flavorful flesh. The word is probably from an Italian dialect, and the sentence is, you will find cockazelli, a great multi-purpose zucchini for steaming, frying, slicing, baking, freezing, and even canning.
Cockazelli. C-O-C-O-Z-E-L-L-E. Cockazelli.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Speller 374.
Your word is cinerous.
Cinerous?
Yes, cinerous.
May I have all of the information?
Cinerous is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means a light bluish gray to light gray that is redder and darker than skimmed milk white and very slightly redder than glaucous gray. The first part is from Latin, and the second part is an English combining form. Anna was happy to find a thick coat of cinerous wool of exquisite fineness. Cinerous.
Does this come from the Latin root cinere meaning ash?
Yes, you're on the right track.
Does this come from the suffix us meaning full of or having the characteristics of?
Yes.
C-I-N-E-R-O-U-S.
That is correct.
Next up, we have speller 375.
Okay, your word is vocalese. This is a homonym, so I'm going to give you all the information. The word is pronounced vocalese or vocalese. It's a noun, and it means a jazz vocal style in which the voice emulates an instrumental part. The word is probably an alteration of French, and the sentence is,
With this release, Rio Nito focused on the vocalese style. Vocalese.
Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is vocalese and vocalese.
Okay. And what was the language of origin?
It's probably an alteration of French.
Okay. Vocalese, vocalese.
Vocalese.
Okay, can I restart?
Yeah, sorry about that.
Okay. V-O-C-A-L-I-S-E, vocalese.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-O-C-A-L-E-S-E.
That's okay, right. Thank you.
Next we have speller 409.
Hello.
Hello. I can't quite see you yet. Okay, now I can see you. Your word is enteparema.
Enteparema. Does it come from the Greek root, Latin root, ante, meaning before?
Yes, you're on the right track.
Is this something like, is the definition something related to like speech?
Kind of, yeah. It means a continuation of an epirema following an antistrophe.
Okay. Antepirema. Can you give me all the information?
Yes. Antepirema is the only pronunciation. It's a noun, and it means the continuation of an epirema following an antistrophe. The word comes from two Greek parts, and the sentence is, she suffered from antepirema and had to be taken to the hospital. Antepirema.
Antepirema. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, anteparema.
Okay, could you repeat the sentence?
She suffered from anteparema and had... Okay, so... Sentence is a bit off. I'll give you a different sentence. In our linguistics class, we learned about anteparema.
Okay. Anteparema. Am I pronouncing it correctly? Anteparema?
Yeah.
Anteparema. A N T E P I R R H E M A. Anteparema?
Yes, that is correct.
Next up, we have speller 411.
Okay, keep your hands in the frame. Your word is vichyssoise.
Vichyssoise?
Yeah.
Can I please have all the information?
The word can be pronounced vichyssoise, 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 vichyssoise. The word is a noun, and it means a soup typically made of pureed leeks or onions and potatoes, cream, and chicken stock, and usually served cold. This word went from a French geographical name to French. And the sentence is, vichyssoise is typically served cold, and it may be garnished with snipped chives or parsley.
Vichyssoise, can you give me all the information again?
Yes. So we're going to pronounce vichyssoise, 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 vichyssoise. It's a noun, and it means a soup typically made of pureed leeks or onions and potatoes, cream and chicken stock, and usually served cold. This word went from a French geographical name to French, and the sentence is, vichyssoise is typically served cold, and it may be garnished with snipped chives or parsley. Vichyssoise.
Vichyssoise. Can you please give me the language of origin again?
Yes, this word went from a French geographical name to French.
And can you repeat all the pronunciations?
Yes. Vichyssoise, 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 vichyssoise.
Vichyssoise, vichyssoise.
30 seconds more.
Vichyssoise.
Sounds right.
V-E-T-H-I-E-S-U-A. Can I restart, please?
Yeah.
V-E-C-H-I-E-S-U-A-S-E.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is V-I-C-H-Y-S-S-O-I-S-E.
Okay.
Great job, Mickey, this far.
Next speller is speller 413.
Hi.
Your word is redendum.
Okay, can I have the, is this a legal term?
Yeah, close. It's a clause in a deed, usually following the tenendum, by which some new thing is reserved out of what had been granted before.
Okay, is this Latin?
Yes, it's from Latin.
Okay, can I have the first speech?
Redendum is a noun.
Does this come from Latin noun suffix?
Meaning?
Latin noun suffix, like, suffix?
I don't see that here.
Okay, redundum, could you repeat the word?
Redundum.
Okay, R-E, sorry, can I start over, please?
You want me to say the word again?
Yeah.
Redundum.
Okay, R-E-D-D-E-N-D-U-M, redundum.
That is correct.
Next, and the last speller of the round, we have speller 415.
Here.
Your word is Demerol.
Demerol. Can you please repeat the word?
Demerol.
Demerol. Can I please have the definition?
Demerol means, Demerol is used for a synthetic narcotic drug used in the form of crystalline hydrochloride as an analgesic, sedative, and antispasmodic. Demerol is a trademark.
Demerol. Can I please have the language of origin?
It's from a trademark.
Demerol. Can I please have the part of speech?
It's a trademark.
Demerol. Demerol. Can I please have the sentence?
Yeah. One of the known symptoms of Demerol withdrawal is insomnia.
Demerol. Demerol. Can you please repeat the word one more time?
Yeah. Demerol or Demerol?
Demerol. Demerol?
Yeah, there are two pronunciations, Demerol or Demerol.
Demerol. Demerol. Can I have the definition?
30 seconds more.
It means used for a synthetic narcotic drug used in the form of crystalline hydrochloride as an analgesic, sedative, and antispasmodic.
Demerol. Demerol. D. E. M. O. R. O. L. Demerol.
So close, just off by one letter. The correct spelling is D-E-M-E-R-O-L. Great job on making it this far.
All right, great job, everyone. That concludes round three. We have had 6 spellers eliminated in this round, which means we will have 13 spellers moving on to round 4. And those who have been eliminated in this round, round 3, are tied for 14th place. Great job, everyone.
Okay, so
can you
first speller?
Can you just hold? I think there is an appeal.
Yeah.
So, does this mean we're taking a break?
Yeah, I think, yeah, I could take a break. This will take at least 5 minutes, right? But judges, please stay on. We don't know what the appeal is.
There's 13 people remaining to answer the question in the chat box.
So, Rohan, can you see the message I sent?
Yes.
Phone. So the thing is that I have to discuss about the appeal, right? Because the other thing is life. So you saw the appeal, right? So did you want Soham?
Yeah.
Soham also on the call?
Yes, so we saw it was coming in the chat. So basically, the definitions are different. One thing is the singing exercise, the other is the time of singing, the last time of singing.
Oh. So what do you think?
I think we should deny the appeal.
Okay. We'll go with that. Rohan, you want? Once we come on, you can announce the reason also, maybe, right?
Yeah,
one of you, who wants to announce it?
So, do I need to, how specific do I need to be when I announce it? Do I need to just say, like, the definition, the AP was over Holland, and the definitions are different enough, is that good enough?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, just justify whatever you think is right, and then they say, you know, that you are denying it, yeah.
If you want to confirm with Soham, you can do that.
It's already done that.
Oh, already done. Okay, good. Okay, Rohan. We'll get back on.
Okay, so the appeal was over a homonym, and the judges have decided that since the homonym has a significant enough the difference between the definitions is significant enough, and because we notified the speller it was a homonym and provided them all the information, we are going to deny the appeal.
So we will continue with 13 spellers remaining, right?
Yes.
First speller of round 4 is speller 304.
Your word is epirogyny.
Epirogyny. Can I have all the information, please?
Epirogyny is the only pronunciation. It's a noun and it means the deformation of the Earth's crust by which the broader features of relief are produced. It comes from two originally Greek parts, and the sentence is, G. K. Gilbert, in 1890, described the process of mountain building as distinguished from epirogyny.
Okay, can I say epirogyny again?
Epirogyny comes from two originally Greek parts.
Okay, I'm just going to ask this. Does this come from, I think, the Greek root pyro, meaning pyro?
I don't see that here.
Okay. Epirogyny. Am I saying this correctly?
Can you say it again?
Epirogyny.
Sounds correct.
Epirogyny. E-P-E-I-R-O-G-E-N-Y. Epirogyny.
Yes.
Thank you.
Next speller is speller 305.
Hello.
Hi. Your word is Harrigan.
Say it again.
Harrigan.
Harrigan, am I saying it right?
Harrigan, yeah, that sounds right.
Definition, please.
A member of the outcast group in India.
Harrigan. Any other pronunciations?
There is just the one, Harrigan.
Harrigan?
Harrigan.
Harrigan, okay. First language origin.
Harrigan is from Sanskrit.
Harrigan. Okay, Sanskrit. So what's that finishing again?
It means a member of the outcast group in India.
Harrigan. Harrigan. H-A-R-U-J-A-N, Harrigan.
You're just off by one letter. The correct spelling is H-A-R-I-J-A-N.
Thank you.
Great job making this far.
Next speller is speller 306.
Hi.
Hi. Your word is cryophore.
Cryophore. May I have all the information, please?
The word came from cryophore or cryophore. It's a noun and it means a statue, figurine, or other representation in ancient art of a man carrying a ram. The word went from two Greek parts to French, and the sentence is, the cryophore was made a very long time ago, and you can find it in the art museum. Cryophore.
Cryophore. C-R-I-O-P-H-O-R-E. Cryophore.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next up is speller 317.
Hi.
Can't see you yet. Okay, now I can see you. Your word is mellophone.
Mellophone. May I have the definition, please?
It means an alt horn in circular form, sometimes used as a substitute for the French horn.
Mellophone. Could you, are there any alternate pronunciations, please?
There is just the one, mellophone.
Mellophone. May I have the language of origin, please?
The first part is from Middle English and the second part is from Greek.
Mellophone. M E L L O P H O N E. Mellophone.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next up is speller 319.
Your word is flamen.
Flamen. Can I...
This word is a homonym.
Yeah, this word is a homonym, so I'll give you all the information. The word's only pronunciation is flamen. It's a noun, and it means a mammalian behavior in which the animal inhales with the mouth open and upper lip curled to facilitate exposure of Jacobson's organ to a scent or pheromone. The word is from German, and the sentence is, the biology teacher demonstrated the flamen behavior to the class. Flamen.
Flamen, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one, flamen.
Can you repeat the part of speech?
Yeah, flamen.
The part of speech.
Oh, the part of speech, sorry, I thought you said pronunciation. It's a noun.
Okay, flamen. F-L-E-A-M-E-N.
Did you hear that last part?
Could you please just repeat that?
F-L-E-H-M-E-N.
That is correct. So
Max Speller is Speller 323.
Okay, your word is iterate.
Could you repeat the word?
Iterate.
Iterate. Okay, could you say all the information, please?
Where can you pronounce irorate or irorate? It's an adjective, and it means covered with little spots or speckled. The word is from Latin, and the sentence is, the tawny butterfly had black irorate wings. Irorate.
Okay. Could you say all the pronunciations again?
Irorate or irorate.
Irorate?
Irorate or irorate?
Okay. Irorate?
Irorate. Irorate.
Okay, irorate. Could I have the part of speech?
It's an adjective.
Okay. Irorate? Irorate. I R O R A T E.
So close, you're just off by one letter. The correct spelling is I R R O R A T E. Great job on making it this far.
Sorry about that, my internet cut out.
Do we know the next speller?
The next, yeah. Speller 326.
Okay.
Hi.
Your word is collyrium.
Collyrium. Can I have the definition?
Collyrium means eye wash or an eye lotion.
Collyrium.
Collyrium.
Can I have language version, please?
Yes. Collyrium went from Greek to Latin.
Collyrium. Does it have the Latin diminutive? Yum, neuter gender.
I don't see that.
Wait, I can't see you.
Yeah, sorry, can someone pin me?
I don't know how. I can't do. Because I'm not the host.
Stronger.
Yeah, it does not have that root.
Okay. Collyrium, can I have the part of speech, please?
Yes, collyrium is a noun.
Collyrium, are there any alternate pronunciations?
There is just the one collyrium.
30 seconds more.
Collyrium, could you repeat the word, please?
Collyrium.
C-O-L-L-Y-R-I-U-M. Am I correct?
That is correct.
Thank you.
Yes.
Rock and roll.
I'm so hungry.
Sorry. Next up is speller 330.
Your word is Schoenfelsite.
Could you repeat that, please?
Schoenfelsite.
Could I have all the information, please?
Yes, the word can be pronounced Schoenfelsite, Schoenfelsite, Schoenfelsite. The word is a noun, and it means a feldspar-free basalt, and the first part is a German geographical name, and the second part is a German part. The sentence is, the stone that we found turned out to be Schoenfelsite.
Could you repeat all of the information, please?
Yes, so the word can be pronounced Schoenfelsite, Schoenfelsite, Schoenfelsite. It's a noun, and it means a feldspar-free basalt, and the first part is from a German geographical name, and the second is a German part. The sentence is, the stone that we found turned out to be Schoenfelsite.
Could you repeat the pronunciations?
Schoenfelsite, Schoenfelsite, Schoenfelsite.
Okay, Schoenfelsite. Could you repeat the definition again?
Yes, a feldspar-free basalt.
Could you repeat the language of origin?
Yeah, the first part is from a German geographical name, and the second is a German part.
S-C-H-O... E-N-F-E-L-Z-I-T-E, Schoenfelsite.
I'm sorry, that is incorrect. The correct spelling is S-C-H-O-N-F-E-L-S-I-T-E. Great job on making it this far.
Next up is speller 354.
Your word is Sorrentine.
Sorrentine. Okay, Sorrentine. Can I have the definition?
Sorrentine means relating to, situated, inhabiting, or coming from a town in Italy.
Okay, Sorrentine. Okay, can I have all the information?
Yes, so the word can be pronounced Sorrentine or Sorrentine. It's an adjective, and it means relating to, situated in, inhabiting, or coming from a town in Italy. It's from Italian, or sorry, more specifically, it's from an Italian geographical name. And the sentence is, John brought some unique Sorrentine artwork when he visited Italy.
Sorrentine?
Sorrentine.
Sorrentine. S O R E N T I N E. Sorrentine?
So close, just off by one letter. The correct spelling is S O R R E N T I N.
Okay.
Great job making this fun.
Next, we have speller 370.
Hi.
Hi. Can't see you yet. Okay, I can see you. Your word is beetle. It's a homonym, so I'll give you all the information. The word's only pronunciation is beetle. It's a noun, and it means a roughly shaped stone held sacred or worshipped as of divine origin. The word went from Greek to Latin, and the sentence is, the Phoenicians worshipped the beetle because they believed it was sacred.
Beetle. Can I have the definition one more time?
A roughly shaped stone held sacred or worshipped as of divine origin.
Beetle. Are there any alternate pronunciations?
Just the one, beetle.
Can I have the language of origin?
Beetle went from Greek to Latin.
Can you please repeat the word?
Beetle.
Beetle. B-A-E-T-Y-L. Beetle.
That is correct.
Thank you.
Next up, we have speller 374.
Your word is pharaoh.
Pharaoh,
man. What's the homonym? I'll give you all the information. Sorry about that. The word can be pronounced pharaoh, pharaoh, pharaoh. It's a noun, and it means a gambling game in which players bet on cards drawn from a dealing box. It comes from an alteration of Latin, and the sentence is, Henry and his friends plan to spend their Friday evening playing a game of pharaoh, but this time with a prize money of $100. Pharaoh.
Pharaoh. F-A-R-O. Pharaoh.
That is correct.
And our next speller is speller 409.
Hello.
Hello. Your word is remolos.
Could you repeat the word?
Ramelos.
Ramelos, may I have all the information?
Yes. Ramelos is the only pronunciation. It's an adjective and it means bearing little branches. The first part is from Latin, the second part is from Latin, and the third part is from English. The sentence is, Jay decided she wanted only Ramelos plants in her front yard as she wanted the view from her study to be unobstructed. Ramelos.
Ramelos, am I pronouncing it correctly? Ramelos?
Sounds right.
Okay, Ramelos, could you repeat the sentence?
Jane decided she wanted only Ramelos plants in her front yard as she wanted the view from her study to be unobstructed. Ramelos.
Could you... Ramelos. Could you repeat all the information?
Ramelos is the only pronunciation. It's an adjective, and it means bearing little branches. The first part's from Latin, the second part's from Latin, the third part is from English, and the sentence is, Jane decided she wanted only Ramelos plants in her front yard as she wanted the view from her study to be unobstructed. Ramelos.
Okay. Ramelos. Does it contain the Greek Latin root os, meaning bearing?
Yes.
Okay. Ramelos. R A M E L-L-O-S-E, Ramelos?
That is correct.
And our last speller of the round is speller 413.
Your word is sycamine.
Okay, sycamine. Can I have all the information, please?
The working pronouns to sycamine or sycamine, it's a noun and it means a tree of the genus Morus. The word is from Latin, and the sentence is, the sycamine tree finds lots of mention in both Greek and Hebrew literature. Sycamine.
Could you repeat the language of origin?
Sycamine is from Latin.
Okay, sycamine. Can you use in a sentence, please?
The sycamine tree finds lots of mentions in both Greek and Hebrew literature. Sycamine.
Okay, sycamine. S-Y-C-A-M-I-N-E, sycamine.
That is correct.
Thank you.
All right, that concludes round four. Great job, everyone. So we have 4 spellers who have spelled incorrectly and 9 spellers who have spelled correctly. These 9 spellers will be moving on to the next round. And those who have been eliminated in this round will have tied for 10th place.
There is an appeal. And there is one more appeal. There were 2 appeals.
Yeah, we'll be giving you guys more information as soon as we've considered the appeals. But thanks for all the questions.
Okay, so the judges have discussed both appeals. The first appeal was over the word Schoenfelsite. The speller appealed saying that we gave him three pronunciations when there were two, but there are actually, in fact, three in the Merriam-Webster unabridged because there's an R in parentheses, and when you have a letter in parentheses, that means there's one pronunciation with it, one pronunciation without it. So if you add that, there are two with the involving one without the R, one with the R, and then one with a long O. So that is three. So that appeal is declared invalid by the consensus of the judges. The speller also appealed over round balance. Round balance is not exactly a valid appeal. We do not accept appeals over round balance. The second appeal was over the word Harajan. The speller claimed that in the Merriam-Webster abridged, the pronunciation is Harajan, which is different from the one we gave him. But in Merriam-Webster unabridged, there is the pronunciation that we gave. So since we give the pronunciation from the Merriam-Webster unabridged, and at the beginning we declared in the rules that all information will be taken from the unabridged, we declared that appeal invalid.
So, Rohan, there is one more appeal now. It should be coming your way.
Okay. We'll take care of that. Okay, so there was an appeal over the word Rory. The speller claimed that the stress was the stress given in the pronunciation was different from that of the Merriam-Webster dictionary. But all the judges convened and they we all agreed that it was pronounced correctly, so the appeal will be denied.
So with that, we have 9 students who will be advancing to the grand finals, right? Congratulations to all of you. It was a great, great week.
Congratulations to everyone who participated. Congratulations to the finalists. Great job, everybody.
Thank you, judges.
Thank you so much, and good job to all of the other finalists.
Okay, everyone, and including all the finalists. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. We'll rejoin back soon. Rohan, Soham, Sneha, take a break.
Okay.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Okay. Thanks.
Bye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Record.